Comrades and friends, I have come here today to express my solidarity and support with your struggle. As a former president of the JNU Students Union, when I reached here, I recalled the first strike ever called by the JNU Students Union in 1974. That was the first one-day strike called by the union. And we had a charter of demands on which, before the strike, a key issue was the admission policy in this university. How can we make the admission policy a national policy, an inclusive policy? And we had a vice chancellor at that time, the first vice chancellor, G. Parthasarathy. Since the admission policy of this university was decided and not being implemented, under the leadership of the students' union, we went and geroed the vice chancellor. He was a very person, a very outstanding diplomat of our country, and after 3 or 4 hours of the Girao, the then Union Minister for Home telephoned him and said, "We are sending in the police to get you out." And he said, "Don't do it over my dead body. Tradition set in the university. I'm afraid now you have a new vice chancellor and you have seen how he has behaved in this situation. I would only like to say that this attack on JNU, this attack on the student community in JNU, is in one sense predictable, because you have seen in the last 20 months since the Modi government came into office, every university, every higher educational institution under the purview of the central government is under siege. There is a plan drive by the BJP and the RSS to impose their political and ideological hegemony over all these institutions.
Shame.
And we saw what happened last year at the IIT in Madras when they prohibited the Ambedkar Periyar study circle. We saw what they tried to do in the University of Pondicherry, another central university. You can see what they're trying to do in the University of Allahabad against the Democratic Students organizations there. And we saw what happened in the University of Hyderabad just a few weeks ago. So JNU is a prime target for this regime. And make no mistake, this has been directed from the top, from the government itself.
Shame.
Shame. Shame.
We know Sri Rajnath Singh. I think people in UP know he was a lecturer in a college there. And he used to be in the RSS Shaka in those days. And he has personally directed the police operation in JNU.
Yeah.
In the University of Hyderabad, we saw how another union minister from Hyderabad got the government, got the HRD minister to intervene. The least said about the HRD minister, the better here. I don't want to get into it. But I was in Calcutta on the day your the police came into the campus. And the next day when I opened the newspaper, I found the most appropriate characterization of our HRD minister. She was in a police uniform. And there was a title, I can't recall exactly. Yogi Okabi, student lady. Now this is the regime which has launched this attack on JNU. The first thing that strikes me is that they have targeted the president of the Students Union and other office bearers of the Students Union. And that's because this Students Union, which I said started in 1972, when some of us got together and decided we must have a union and we drafted a constitution and got the university to say, we will do it, you don't get into it, but just allow us to form this union. That union has withstood more than 5 decades of all the other time the union gave a strike call, in one sense similar to the situation today, was when the police entered the campus during the emergency to arrest the president of the union and by mistake arrested another student. His name is Prabir Purukaisa, he's still around. And because they had arrested him, they could not admit they had made a mistake, so they put him under the Maintenance of Internal Security Act for the whole emergency period. At that time, again, most of the union office bearers could not function openly. And against this police intervention, a strike call was given. The first strike call in an educational institution during the emergency. And there was one counselor at that time, I recall, who signed that statement, Ashok Lata Jain. And she was rusticated from this university, expelled. But the union survived. It survived the emergency. And therefore, I'm fully confident that the attack which has been launched this time will also be foiled, rebuffed by you. The BJP government and the RSS. It's not now. In this last more than 5 decades, the RSS has always branded this university as a den of anti-national elements. And we in this university have always challenged their nationalism, what they call nationalism. We know what their nationalism is. The same Narendra Modi and his ilk, their nationalism stops at the doors of the White House in America. Nationalism is forgotten. We know that you have an RSS Pracharak as the Prime Minister who is proud to declare during this election campaign that I am a Hindu nationalist. So we do not accept this nationalism. We challenge that nationalism. And you are using the Indian Penal Code Section 124A, sedition. Last year, in Trivandrum, in Kerala, in a cinema hall, some young people did not stand up when the national anthem was played after the film. They were all arrested under sedition. And they spent 2 weeks in jail before they got bail. So, this sedition clause is used widely, indiscriminately in our country. If you oppose the Kudankulam nuclear plant, you are considered to be acting against the state. You declared war on the state. More than 1,000 people were charged with sedition during that struggle. If you conduct any protest, any movement, you can be hauled under the sedition charge. So therefore, our basic demand has always been scrap the sedition clause in the Indian Penal Code. And the legal battle will be there, and I'm sure we can conduct that legal battle successfully, where we can show that this clause has been used maliciously and indiscriminately against the students of this university. I'd also like to mention here that in your struggle, this is not a JNU struggle alone, because this has become a much wider struggle. What you are fighting to defend is something much wider. Secularism, democracy, the right to free expression, all the constitutional rights which are given to the citizens of this country are under attack, and this attack is concentrated against you in JNU because you represent the most advanced, organized, conscious sections of the democratic student community. You are not alone. Well, I come from the first generation of JNU students, but all successive generations of students who have studied in this university are with you. That the teachers of this university have come forward and are standing by you solidly. In every university campus, in every educational institution, students are standing up in your support. Because this attack, yesterday, some people came to our office and wrote on our board, Pakistani office. Now, these people do not know the history of our party. We have been called pro-Chinese, pro-Pakistani, all sorts of names. In 1965, when the war broke out between India and Pakistan, all we said was, this is a futile war. Negotiate and settle the problems. Talk, open talks. This war is useless. For that we were all put in jail, all our leaders. And we were branded as anti-national. So calling us pro-Pakistani is not something new for us. We are used to it. We are not in the least bothered about what they tell us about Kashmir. Our party clearly came out against the execution of Afzal Guru. Not because we agree with his politics or his positions, but because we felt there was a judicial miscarriage of justice. We are against capital punishment. We are not for hanging anyone. So we are not going to be cowed down by labels like anti-national, Deshdrohi, etc. The real patriots of this country, the real patriots of the country are the people who stand with the common people, who stand for the interests of the working people, who also will stand up against the rulers, the ruling class, whenever they attack the interests and rights of the people. So, on this occasion, I would like to congratulate you, because in the last 4 days, you have shown by your unity, by your determination and your struggle, the JNU students and the JNU community will defend and protect whatever JNU has stood for always. It will be a hard battle, but you will win this battle. You will fight.